the great things about Credo is there's always somebody available to step in when something happens. My colleague Jim Hausman didn't know he was going to be playing this piano part, but the need arose, and he's here. So thanks to Jim Hausman. In Ukraine started just before, just as people were thinking about coming to Credo. So we mobilized our students to do a practice-a-thon. They were all practicing anyway, so many of them got pledges. And together, they worked and they raised nearly $6,000 for children in Ukraine. So bravo to all of you. And it wasn't completely altruistic. We incentivized the person who practiced the most hours and the person who raised the most money. So we're going to recognize those people now. The person who gave us the most hours of practicing was Ty Pfeiffer. And the individual that raised the most money was Alana Schubert.
Thank you.
I can geek out for a minute here musically, Mozart Adagio and Fugue presents some interesting problems because it's written by Mozart, who is not a Baroque composer, but it's a Baroque form. So we have some very interesting ideas, interesting choices about it. We all know that Mozart died relatively young, and this was written close to the end of Mozart's time. Think of the pieces you may know by Mozart, some of his early symphonies, or the so-called papaya quartet, the Hund quartet, papaya, papaya, papa. Anyway, think of those pieces, eine kleine Nachtmusik, and then compare it to this. And imagine what would have happened to the history of music if Mozart had lived another 20 or 30 years. Tradition. Every Credo season has ended with the members of the orchestra giving each other a benediction by Peter Lutkin called "The Lord Bless You and Keep You." So if you know this one, please join us. We rehearsed the playing a little bit more than the singing. So if you want to join in this benediction, please feel free to. Credo alumni, feel free to come to the stage.